I feel so wonderfully content in this moment right now. My mind feels free and relaxed. I am enjoying the sophistication and luxury.
And welcome to TikTok Live here at Bloom From Within Love. I'm back. I go by Bloomy. And I'm just here.
I enjoy feeling a part
under the inspiration of what I've been guided to do. And I was going to put it off because I was like, well, I just did like a 2-hour reading. So I think I want to put it off. But I kept getting it, kept feeling
feel
it, so
tremendously great.
I think I'm going to come on back in here and just share with you guys basically what I said I would. I mentioned that I was going to come back and share some things regarding emotions, but as well as sexual addiction. I don't know if I said that part, but it's twofold. So for those of you, I wanted to say welcome, those of you coming in, okay? Most folks are busy. I mean, it's Labor Day weekend and it's, you know, time to be like partying and doing y'all things. So I'd be quite shocked if anybody actually come on tonight. But for those of you who are here, I just want to say welcome and thank you for joining. And those of you who come in with that positive vibes, I want to say thank you. It may be amplified to you. Where you need it.
For every moment of flowing wealth in my life.
Yeah, baby. What you hear is one of my faves on YouTube.
I enjoy the feeling of receiving wealth.
Take that in, y'all. As
the
y'all come in,
flow of dollars
I'm going to turn it down a little bit when I start talking here. Yep, there's that throat. So this is good. It's going
to
be for somebody. So, you guys, it's not an official tarot reading. It's more going to be oracle and a discussion is what I was guided to do. I've been getting so many downloads and so many confirmations, and I'll be listening to something and it'll click. And so now I'm just sharing it per my guidance for those of you who will relate to it. So if this message and discussion has nothing to do with your life, then this is probably not for you today, and that's okay. All right? But there is a collective of people that this message, this channel, these oracles regarding emotions and sexual addiction is going to be for, even if it's about someone that's on their mind. Okay? And the stuff that I've been getting is powerful, and I'm just like, it has me in awe. Like,
I feel so.
I almost don't even know what to say. And I'm a woman of many words, if you guys haven't figured that out yet.
So, what I want to do.
To have me kind of stuck and kind of stunned is amazing. Life altering.
I have a profoundly
potentially
fulfilling career.
Just depends on how we take it and how we apply it, right? So anyways, yes, it's going to be a discussion slash oracle. I'm guided to simply oracles, and it's going to be based on either yourself, somebody in your life, where you're at, where you're going, as it pertains to the emotion body, how you feel about emotion, but sidebar as well as sexual addiction and how that may be playing out in some way. But it's going to be strictly oracle.
I have an
okay
inspiration,
and please don't take
something.
Offense, because I do want to say as a disclaimer, I was listening to someone and they made perfect clear sense. Let me turn this down, because I know people can be kind of touchy, and trust me, that's not my energy. You guys see me go ratchet and kind of go a little
I get to choose my
y'all see me get kind of like riled up, and that's due to injustice. When you guys see my energy go that way, I'm picking up something, and I'm it's my energy facing off with an energy that is toxic to pure beings or people that meant no harm. And so you guys will hear me like rowl up like that. But my pure heart, my pure energy, I am not one to life is life, and we all go through things. We all make mistakes. We've all come from something. We all have a story, you know, and I get that.
That brings a smile to my face.
I just want to say that. I don't know why I felt the need to say that.
I know I can afford what
the lion in me has riled up a lot lately, because I used to be so timid. And so it's really in the name of justice. It's not in the name of trying to tear people down. Unfortunately, the people that I'm usually riling up against are the ones that are always hell-bent on trying to tear people down, no matter what they mask it behind. Okay?
I am a generator of wealth and abundance.
But, so I get, like, for, you know, for an example, the topic of addiction. The woman... Who was that light team? I may not even get the quote all the way right, but...
Abundance is my resounding frequency.
Give me a second, guys.
The frequency of wealth and abundance emanates from my body.
Okay, sorry. Okay, so... It was somebody I was listening to, and it just clicked, confirmed what I was feeling. She said that addiction, when we hear addiction, right, any type of addiction, addictive personality, any kinds of addictions, right, an addictive way of life or an addictive behavior, trait, or personality can have, depending, it can have potential devastating effects in your life. And then she mentioned sex. And she said that, she was like, sex addiction. She was like, listen, I know I'm not making excuses for nobody. She was like, but it is a problem, just like we would look at drug addiction, right? Because when people are in addiction, they are destructive, okay? Think about anybody you've ever known, or even yourself, right? If you've gone down a path of drug and alcohol or something, you know, and it ended up being a very destructive path because of it being an addiction, right? So it is with sex. But here is the unique kind of, I want to say the unique darkness about it, is because sex is a natural thing. It's healthy. It's beautiful. So, you know, unlike, you know, let's say gambling, overspending, or doing some type of recreational drug that, you know, or, you know, whatever, or alcohol is already looked upon like, okay, possibly harmful to you. But having sex is a human, natural 3D thing. It's a beautiful thing. And it's meant to be enjoyed. It's meant to be experienced in, you know, right? So this is what makes it even scarier, because it's something that's normal and natural that even the addict themselves won't be able to identify, right? Addicts have a hard time identifying, even if it is something like recreational drugs. It takes them a while. So when it comes to sex, they certainly have a hard time, because to them, it's just that they classify it as, oh, I'm just passionate. I just have a high sex drive. You see how it can get convoluted? But let me explain where this goes awry. Someone, you guys, please hear me out, and I don't mean no disrespect to nobody, and hopefully if you or anybody you know are in a sex addiction, you know, hopefully your higher self or whatever you believe, you kind of get it balanced in your life and get to the root of why it's even there, okay? But sex addiction, if you're trying to deal with somebody with that, let me explain. That's an appetite that is insatiable. Okay, and what I mean by insatiable is this. It don't matter how fine you think you are. It don't matter how much, you know what I'm saying, work you get done, or how much toys you buy, and whatever you try to do to try to fulfill the appetite of that person's sex life, it's never going to be enough, my friend. And it's not because the addict really means harm necessarily, you know what I'm saying? Some of them do, but it's because they're in addiction, and all addictions usually have an insatiable nature. by definition, unsatisfiable. So you can swing off the chandeliers. You can fucking, you know what I'm saying, do all the stuff you think they want you to do. But they'll never be loyal to you. They can't. Because the disease in itself by nature pulls it to wanting constant stimulation and constant variety, no matter how good you think you are. Okay? And then it becomes imbalanced because any normal human being, if they're healthy in life, they're not going to be wanting it at the magnitude of an addicted person. So it can become draining to somebody that's actually sexually healthy, but to somebody that is a sexual addict, they feel like they're being deprived. They feel like it's boring, and then they'll gaslight and use excuses and say that's why they, you know, all of that, because they're trying to fill an empty void and they're addicted. Okay, whether it's a man or a woman, okay, it doesn't matter. Whether that's, you know, that's where they're pulling their ego boost. This is where they're pulling their self-esteem. This is, you feel me? That sex in that way is not healthy.
Now I know, because I have
and many of you have been pondering on that topic within yourself. Like, sexuality. Looking at your past life, looking at people you've dated, looking at where you are. You know, just trying to reflect. So, these kinds of relationships are usually very, very toxic, very, very burdensome. Usually have no potential for nothing healthy, because that's not a healthy behavior. Conditions are typically escapist. And what I mean by that is they don't want to deal with life or reality. They don't want to deal with whatever inner child woundings or pains that are there. And again, this is not meant to be insulting. That's why I said it when I first started. We all have a story. We all have a background. We've all made mistakes. We all come from some level of toxic shit. You know what I'm saying? If you've lived long enough and if you're honest, right? But what the issue is this. The determining factor is individuals that have gotten in a place in their life where they're recognizing things and they're transforming and healing. You know what I'm saying? Versus some people are actually comfortable being there because it's easier and it gives them a payoff. Why should I want to do all this change and transformation? It's going to hurt like fuck. Why should I want to, you know what I'm saying, do this and this and that and not have sex? See, they look at it from that 3D perspective versus looking at it from a holistic perspective. They don't see the destruction. The destruction, meaning the destruction that's on their bodies, you know, because at some point you live fast and loose and that kind of life is fencing to catch up on that ass, right? At some point. So all that energetic sexual intertwining, right? They don't look at that. And if they're really reckless, they don't even have regard for who the hell they're laying with. In terms of who is that? Who the fuck are you laying with? Like an addict. Think about this. An addict, a drug addict, is not finna, let's be honest here. A drug addict ain't finna say, oh, I don't want that piece of crack right there because it was on the floor. They're on crack. Okay? And they need to get that that thing fixed. The thing. They're not going to be talking about, oh, let me see where it's been. They don't care where it's been. They're an addict. Okay? It's not, and please, y'all, I promise you, y'all, I have a diverse background. I mean, I've never been on drugs and alcohol. Knock on wood. That just was not my path. That was not my journey. Okay? But I have a very diverse background. I've experienced it a lot. I've seen it in my family dynamics. I've seen it around me. Trust me. So I'm not trying to be demeaning. Addictions are an emotional and in some cases mental problem. Okay. Sex addiction, beautiful souls, is no exception. Even though it's usually masked as I'm just a passionate person. Or I'm playing catch up because I didn't start having sex until I was 20. right? Healthy sex versus this is addiction. Addiction, that you're not going to be satisfied. You're going to have to go from bed to bed, person to person, constantly, no matter how happy you are in a relationship or no matter how fulfilling that person is, it's still not going to be enough. The eyes are still going to wander and be drawn because it's insatiable. So you guys should ask yourself a question. If you're on the side of you've dealt with people with that, and maybe that's why things don't work. These people typically don't have healthy relationships either because they are unstable and they usually are cheaters. Okay. Sometimes they do get people to commit to them in a long term, but it's usually an individual that maybe have a very low self-esteem, that just want to be able to say they have somebody in their lives or whatever, and they let the person cheat and basically let the person sleep with whoever, you know, or do whatever, as long as they pay the bills or come home or whatever, you know what I'm saying? But those are usually the only cases that they have real long-term relationships, because most people will not stand for it very long. And they'll always violate it and sabotage it in some way. Okay? Due to that out of control sexual energy. Not to mention they end up getting babies in places or having babies they didn't want or getting diseases. Or, you know what I'm saying, people catching feelings, crimes of passion. There's so much destruction that is potentially had from being fast and loose in a sexual addiction. It's not only hard on the body, but look at that potential devastation. It's always a risk every time we lay with somebody. Sorry, hate to break the news. I know nobody don't want to hear that. But that's just the reality. It's there. Every time you're going to bring two human beings and exchange some types of bodily fluids, there's a risk factor. So just think about people who have a sexual addiction gone wild. How many risk factors they're bringing in their lives constantly. I'm not talking about when we all at some point maybe we're young and wild or went through phases as is natural with the development of humanity. I'm not talking about that progression of growth and maturity or healing. I'm talking about, you know, something that is as a lifestyle and it's long past any initiation, 40, 50, 60, beyond 30s even, you know. Running from inner child wounds, running from things, you know what I'm saying? I can relate, understood. But for those of you who are in a different place in life now, okay, maybe you have looked at your own life and you've grown, you've balanced out, and you're looking at your relationships in retrospect and you're just like, And some of you may be looking at potential people that you're with. And you're like, wait a minute. So I feel like this is why this discussion is coming out about sexuality. So I'm going to stop right there. I don't want to mix the conversations together. So as I'm on the topic of the sexual addiction, let's get the pulse there. And then when I switch topics to the emotions, which is a whole nother something, y'all. And that's a trip too. I'm going to admit that. But I'm going to try to keep it a little bit clean and simple so it don't feel like it's like bleeding over on y'all, okay? So right now, this is a general collective reading discussion, oracle, not tarot, oracle, and discussion on sexual addiction, okay? Maybe how it's affected your life, where you're at, or those that you have chosen, whether it is you that shows up here or, you know, people that were sex addicts that you've chosen, kind of the areas that was hid, and then maybe what the message is. Okay, because it's all intuitive. I'm rolling with the guidance, you guys. So if you set your intention and this is something that you feel like is for you and you want to know, you know, that amplifies me picking up on your energy and pulling it into the reading. Okay. All right. Thank you, Light Team. So they just asked me to divide it to divine, to divide it to feminine, masculine, to help people. So whether you're a man or a woman, no matter what, but since it's energy based, to reveal where it's been in the masculine energy, where it's been in the feminine energy, okay? And then whatever intuitive guidance they give, okay? Hope that helps. We're gonna start with masculine, okay? And I'm just hearing masculine. That's why you guys heard me change it up, because we're not really talking about divine nature. Divine nature, when we start coming into divine nature, we've dealt with this kind of stuff. Even if that was our path, we've dealt with it. Okay? So we're just speaking on masculine and feminine energy. Okay? Already, I'm already getting messages. Wow. Wasn't expecting that. Okay. Jesus Christ, man. All right, so we have the warrior and we have the high priestess of air. All right, so as for the masculine energy, some of you all may have dealt with air signs. A lot of air signs that had sexual addictions, or you may be an air sign, but it doesn't have to be. Equally, you could have dealt with someone with water, but I'm seeing air. I'm seeing the warrior, and I'm seeing like the Queen of Swords, 6 and 2, lovers. Huh, this is okay. It seemed like the spirit guides, my light team, is giving me a story, like a backdrop of what created the addiction.
Oh, fuck me.
So, y'all, for the masculine, since we're on the masculine side, some of them actually experienced some very brutal feminine energies early. That's why we saw the warrior. Something happened with the feminine energy early in life that opened them up to the addiction, or it's regarding someone from their past with that card, number 6, that had some kind of energy about them that opened the masculine up to a sex addiction. They could have dealt with maybe a stripper. Damn, not that anything's wrong with a stripper, y'all, so don't hate. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm just saying, we're just getting the messages. Because I say that, why, if you're wondering, it says forbidden. So something that was maybe toxic in nature, some kind of a toxic experience very early, okay? Some taboo things maybe that exposed them to some wild and out shit. And because they were in pain, for these masculines, they had mother issues. They had mothers that were like icy cold here. Because the Queen of Swords, if she's not awakened and high vibrational, she don't provide nothing. And if she do say something, it ain't going to usually be good. So some of these masculines grew up with that kind of feminine energy. And then when they started dating, they got introduced early on in their sex life to a feminine energy that maybe turned them out. And you know, due to all that pain inside of them, got them like, it got them like all addicted, y'all. That's kind of where it started. And from there, that's something that they've been using for their pain, like to make them feel like a man, to make them feel emotions. Like for them, even that's where they get the emotional. I don't see how, but I guess they do. I don't see how they're getting it, like, team.
So I can see all the ways the universe is guiding me.
Oh. Okay. Okay. So because some of these masculines only had very rigid feminine energy in their lives when early, like their mom or caretaker, early. Right? Just stiff, cold, icy. And what they found out when they got when a feminine introduced them to some like off the chain sex stuff or whatever, they, to them in their mind, that broke the rigidity in the feminine. They were able to break that rigidity because when they had the sex like that, then they were able to feel and see the feminine in a softer form, because she wasn't no longer the stern, aggressive or unfeeling. She was moaning. She was groaning. She was oohing and aahing, and in some cases crying, or, you know, depending on the feminine. So to the masculines, they felt like, oh, this is how I break the feminine's rigidity, is through sex. And it felt good. It made them feel empowered. It made them feel strong, because when they grew up or early on, they didn't feel that way, because they were around icy as hell feminine energies. Okay. Wow. I was not expecting that. Okay. Now I get it, light team. Now I see why y'all have me doing it. This is interesting. So, look at this. High Priestess of Spirit. Look at this, y'all. Huh. See, this is where they feel alive. See, this is what I'm saying. Like, when they got the sex and they saw that they could get emotion out of women that way, or how the women reacted and all those things, it made them feel alive. Wow. It made them see or feel like there was a softer side to the feminine versus the icy side to the feminine that they had experienced. So they started associating these sex acts as a way to get to the feminine's emotions too. But that's illusion. And yeah, it's illusion. That's just sex. But that's how they equated it though. Very early. Because, you know, outside of the sex, they're icy cold. In the sex, they're all, you know, whoever these women were early on in life and their experience, their sex experience, the caretakers, right? Icy cold. Even the girlfriends that they may have had were probably icy cold. With the exception of in the bedroom. Okay? At least that's from their view. Okay? Look at it. And as I said, that the High Priestess of Water, look at all this feminine energy coming out on the masculine side. That's how he felt like he got to the feminine's emotion. And that became addictive to him. Wow. And yeah, this is where it all got hard. Let me show y'all. No pun intended. But let me show you. Hold on, y'all. No pun intended. So then he got faced with, you know, somewhere there, you know, about choices and stuff, light and dark. And it was hard for him. Some of these masculines are fallen angels, fallen ascended masters or something. Because they knew, for some of the masculines, they started knowing that they were addicted. They started getting a clue for some of them. But they knew they had a choice to go light or dark in terms of, should I go with my higher vibration or should I go with the lower vibration? And that's where they got stuck. That's where a lot of them got stuck. Some of them want to. Like some of the masculines, they want to. They're looking at the purity side of sex, but yeah, it's too much pain and trauma that they don't want to deal with that part because they already know they don't want to. Look it, and as I said that, see, to them, the sex is that instant gratification like magic. They rather just manifest more sex partners than actually deal. Wow. Okay. Thank you, Light Team. For the masculines regarding the sex addiction, whether it's the viewer or someone on their mind, belonging. See, this is how they felt like they connected and belonged somewhere, is through the sex. Because they had icy queens around them early on in life. And this card fell over to the feminine's deck. And see, this is what makes them feel connected and at home with feminine energy. It's through sex. Wow. Yep. Through using sex, through some of them doing sex magic, through just constantly trying to manifest more sex partners when they blow through the other ones or whatever. But it ends up in chaos. Like, I can't make it up. This sex addiction keeps ending in chaos in these masculines' life. Because, see, they lack confidence, but they seek sex to build their confidence, you guys. It's a falseness, but this is what they know. This is what they've been doing. Okay? They think that makes them successful, but it doesn't. They think it's all about, you know, the sex, you know, having sex with beautiful people in the physical form, that makes them successful, but it doesn't. What's really happening is they lack self-worth, and the people they're choosing usually do on some level, okay? Which is only making their lives complicated. Because they end up getting hurt, the fledging. They end up beating people in a way, beating people down due to their destructive behavior. They end up getting beat down. They end up getting a bad reputation. They end up causing scandal. Anybody in a sex addiction energy usually is going to have a trail. A lot of taboo sexual activities. A lot of things that are secret and unknown and considered forbidden, right? Wow. Risky behavior, and most of them are in denial about it. Wow. Okay, team, so moving on. Okay. Hold on, guys. Okay. I'm just trying to make sure I'm getting the guidance here. Okay, for feminine like team. Aww, look at feminine. Love and inner child. Okay, so straight away for feminine energy, the feminine's plight, for the feminines that had a sex addiction, or if the feminine didn't have the sex addiction, she just appeased it in masculine energy, it was due to her seeking love and due to her inner child wound. Okay, that's on the feminine side.
I enjoy the feeling of receiving wealth.
She was seeking love. The masculine was seeking belonging.
Continuous flow of dollars into my account.
Wow.
I love to think about all.
And for the feminines, they felt like, if you're a feminine that either you were an addict, or let's say you just dealt with the masculines that were the addicts, you felt like the only way they'd hear you was through sex. It says, say what you mean. So many of you, because of that inner child and some of the cultural conditionings and things that you saw, you felt like, okay, the masculine is not going to hear me. The only way he hears me is if I appease his sexuality. He won't hear me. He won't hear what I say. He won't hear me. He won't speak the truth to me. That's why the feminines did it. The conditioning to use sex. The beliefs and the media propaganda that if you're wild and out, that you can make a masculine love you. If you're wilding out with them, that they would commit to you. If you're wilding out with them and do all the sexual things, that they'll be with you forever and they'll never leave you and they'll appreciate you and they'll value you. But it was in the name of trying to find real love, and it never happened. Because sex addiction is an addiction. It's not going to happen. Yeah. You guys were dreaming of finding love, feminine. This is for the feminine side here. Whether you were a feminine addict of sex or you dealt with masculines with addictions to sex. Some of the feminines felt victimized by this stuff. You felt victimized, some of you feminines, due to this pursuit of love, through sex, you know what I'm saying, even when you were not the addict, but you felt victimized to masculine's addictions. Okay. Because you guys too were on a journey of self-love and hadn't discovered that either.
With total bees.
It just manifests different.
My experiences.
Wow. Okay, thank you, Light Team. We're on the side of the feminine. As it relates to sex addiction, whether it is the feminine or people that she's dated, Light Team, for the feminine, this message is for the feminine sex addiction, whether she's the one or she's dealt with the, okay. Oh, shit. Do y'all see that? Oh, fuck me. Did y'all, oh, it jumped on to the masculine. Did y'all see that though? Soulmate. So what I'm picking up with this right away is that for the feminine relating to this topic, the feminine has been on an endless pursuit of wanting a soulmate, okay? Of trying to find her soulmate, okay? And because of that, some of these feminines developed a sex addiction themselves. Others of the feminines, they just continued to, it dropped onto the masculine. They continued to appease the sexual addiction of the masculine, hoping that this is going to make what I said, that it's going to make him, oh, this is us forever. Nah, the fuck. Okay. The feminines were very creative, these feminines, obviously. They're very creative, and so the feminines in this reading and discussion was trying to use that creativity with the sex, hoping that it'll, you know, it'll make the man or girl, because it could be same sex, hoping that it'll make them want to be forever. Like, if I'm creative, right, then they gonna be, you know what I'm saying, they gonna commit to me finally. You heard me? They'll stop procrastinating. Okay. If I'm creative sexually with him, he'll stop procrastinating and he'll finally see me as beautiful. And, you know, then he'll finally see me as the family, the person he wants to be with to build a family. Okay. Wow. Wow, y'all. Whoa. That's all I got to say. Masculine side, feminine side here. Whoa. Fuck me.
I feel so good.
Okay, team. Is there anything else I need to do with in respect to this before I go over to the emotion side? So, sexual addiction, you guys. If there's a sexual addiction in any dynamic, same sex, opposite sex, whatever, that is not the ticket to a happy connection, a happy marriage, a happy whatever. It's never going to fulfill. It only has potential for disaster. Somebody's going to always, it's going to be a hot mess. Lives can get hurt physically, sexually, mentally, emotionally. It's demeaning. It's never going to build self-worth and self-esteem. Okay? It's very demeaning. Are we not more than our bodies? Are we not more than our sexual experience? Do we not have more value beyond? Should we not care who we lay our bodies with? Wow. And I'm not saying this to be like hard on us. It's like, it's to point us at the reality that there's a deeper issue at play. There's a deeper issue at play. There's some inner healing and transformation needing to happen. That doesn't make us the bomb. If we can have sex with 12 holes, it don't make us the bomb because we can back the one that got a huge ass. It don't make us the bomb because we can back the one that's got a huge penis. You know what I'm saying? Like, for real. I'm just saying. Balance is needed.
And how to use it to benefit as many people as possible.
And forgiveness of, you know, those who were in the sexual addiction, like the things that they experienced early, like their parents, you know, where they got these misconceptions about feminine or masculine energy. Yeah, because for the feminine, it's more about an absence of masculine. She was looking for love from masculine, and the masculine was looking to connect with the emotion or fit in with the feminine. He had cold feminine energy. The feminine had an absence of masculine. Or, and if she had it, it was just as cold. If she had it, it was kind of culturized to have her to use her body and her beauty and her sexuality. If she did have it. So many of you are going through a spiritual awakening right now and are coming to realize, like, okay, something has to give with the sexuality. There's nothing wrong with sex. Sex is a very natural and beautiful thing. But from this sexual addiction, you guys are starting to realize, like, spiritual awakening in the house. And you're trying to forgive yourself for, like, maybe your past things. And maybe you're trying to forgive some of the lovers that, you know, maybe some of these masculines or feminines that maybe hurt you or exploited you in some way due to that addiction, right? Because I'm telling you guys, destruction happened in this shit. I'm telling y'all, it may sound like it's so attractive and so fun and so, you know, TV makes shit look like that, right? But if we want to play it out in real life, these kinds of dynamics with people who have sex addictions, it's a hot mess. This shit can end up on the damn TV with crimes of passion and shit. You heard me? And then situations with all this, you know, child support, because they didn't mess around and had 12 children created that they weren't paying no attention to, because when you're a sex addict, you're all over the place. You're all over the place. You're reckless. And then the shit come up, though, at some point in life. Woo! And some of you, this stuff runs deep. Some of these masculines come from a lineage of people and had other carnations dealing with a lot of sexual addiction.
I use my time wisely. I have time and money, freedom.
Yeah, it's the shadow. Look at this. And they were being asked, some of these masculines are being asked to do the shadow work so they can get to the root of why that's there. Why they're not healthy sexually, why they can't be faithful, why they can't, you know what I'm saying, be honest, you know, about their sexuality and things like that. Okay. So they just want me to get one for each and move on. Okay. So for the masculine light team, what's the message over here for the masculine side? Yeah. The masculine awakening crystal. So some of these masculines are being called to come to awakening. This is a, I told y'all they were freaking fallen angels. This is a master card. This says master teacher card. I knew it. I told y'all some of these masculines were fallen angels. So some of these people, I'm serious, y'all. In another life, some of these masculines on one of their carnations, they had ascended to like high places or something. I don't know what got screwed up, but they were, I'm telling you. And they came in this carnation. They were supposed to rectify some shiznit. But they didn't do the emotional healing. It was in reverse. Some of them are bucking it. But they're master level. That's why that choice card came out like that. I knew it. God damn it, I knew it. I knew it. Some of them are barely starting to realize it. It's taken them a long time. And I'm saying this because of what they got at the bottom. They got learning. So the masculine side of the sexual addiction, you know, some of them are really starting to see, and it could possibly be to some devastation that I talked about. Okay. They're starting to like, look like, damn, you know what I'm saying? This shit cool and fun for like, until I orgasm. But look at the fuck shit I done created in my life. Look how fucked up I am. Look at the people that I've hurt. all because I you know, my pain, there's some pain here that I'm not looking at. And then I say past life, I told y'all. Some of them are seeing it finally. They're connecting. They see that they were not aware, that they were closed off and not flexible. Ooh, some of them. Some of them still stuck. All right, light team. So for feminine, you guys want this one for the feminine or another one? Hold on, you guys. Talk to me, team. Where are we at?
It feels so refreshing. I look up to see a sight of profound beauty.
Give me a second, you guys. I'm sorry. They want me to switch. I don't know why. I was trying to keep it the same, but okay. Give me a second, you guys. It would have been nice for me to have these cards in advance.
I have never seen such an illumination with these lights in the sky.
Give me a second, guys. I'm right here. I thought I had grabbed all the decks they had.
Seven pinks, various peaches, and the array.
Oh. Different. Okay. I'm coming, guys. Bear with me.
It is so magic.
Okay, here I come. Sorry. Sorry, guys. Okay. I wonder why, though. It would have been cool to have the same deck, but okay. All right. So for the feminine side. All right. What's the message, light team? From the high priestess here. The feminine's dealing with either sexual addiction or kind of was like a geisha and appeasing to the sexual addiction of masculine energy. Interesting already. Huh. Ooh. Okay. So for some of the feminines that suffered due to some kind of a sexual addiction issue, whether it was her own or from appeasing masculine, it was due to a belief system. Belief system and not owning one's power. So it could have been cultural. Again, it could have been how she grew up, the conditioning, the examples that she had displayed in her life and that she saw reinforced constantly, because this was in reverse. Brilliant beliefs was in reverse. So it was her belief system that had the feminine using her sexuality or appeasing to the masculine sexuality in her pursuit of love.
I'm so grateful.
Wow. Wasn't expecting that. Oh, and then many of you are divine feminines that, wow, so how did that happen, Source, Light Team? What happened?
Oh.
All right. So for those of you on the feminine side, many of you are, you came as a divine feminine. So you guys are on the higher level realms like masculine. So you're in a master mode too. But what happened to y'all? It was your belief systems and, like I just said, that cultural conditioning that had you in a mindset and a belief and frequency of, I get to the masculine energy, I get love by using sex, by appeasing to not his sex in the healthy way, but his addiction. And it was because of the beliefs, the conditioning, the culture. For some of you on an Akashic level, yep, just like the masculine had it in his lineage, some of y'all had it on an ancestral level too, or in another life, something like geisha girl shit. And yeah, but you guys are on master level too. So we got, technically we have divine masculine and feminine energy, but this is in its low form, not in divinity, due to sexual addiction of some sort. Yeah. Now, for feminine, though, you guys struggled for a long time to transform, to become something new dealing with this. But some of you have already started the transformation on the feminine side, okay? You got your beliefs on the upright. Okay, wow. Now I see why they wanted me to switch. See, that's why you just listen, Brandy.
Freedom and security.
And as I said, just listen, clairvoyance, inspiration, interpretation, and trust. So many of you were getting guidance and downloads about it, but for a while you resisted it because now it's back in reverse again, becoming something new. Don't ask me how it's doing that. But that's what took so long. But now some of the feminine energies are starting to listen, okay, with that clairvoyance. Regarding the sexual addiction. Oh, see, now you guys are dealing with forgiveness because you guys suffered a lot as a result of this. Forgiveness and removing obstacles, earth magic, because you dealt with hoish masculine energy, predatory, exploitatory masculine energy. But you're taking your power back and realizing that it was equally due to your own belief systems. You're taking your power back in that you realize they were still your choices. And it was based on your faulty system that even allowed it. That even caused you to appease it because you didn't have to. Okay? When you saw that it was kind of unhealthy because y'all did. Y'all high level just like the masculine. When you saw that, you resisted at first due to your inner child woundings, like masculine has an inner child woundings. Okay? But then now you guys are starting to come into alignment like, okay, I need to forgive myself. I need to forgive my family. I need to forgive the parentals, you know, because they was fucked up. They had some fucked up shit, you know what I'm saying? You know, that only reinforced this kind of a toxic, demeaning mindset to the feminine energy that is tolerant and appeases an out of control, sexual, addictive masculine. Okay. Wow. Insanity. And it, oh, feminines. It was due to your fear of loss and lack. So it was abandonment. Because many of you didn't have fathers. And if you had them, he was just as toxic as the damn masculines in the reading. Okay. But many of you didn't. Many of you were abandoned by parental figures that should have been there. That should have cared for you or protected you or taught you better about sexuality and not exploited. God, have mercy. Oh, I'm going to let that go. I'm going to leave that alone. I'm going to leave that alone, light team. That's what feminists went through. And then I say on Akashic Records for you guys, and there's the Akash. It was some ancestral shit. It could also be due to things happened in the past life or the bloodline. Wow.
I know, and I have the evidence.
But the good thing is, there you are, feminine. You're going down another portal, or you're about to. You're awakening to your infinite mind, awakening consciousness to clear that up in your life. So that you don't continue to attract masculines that are distorted or masculines that are in a sexual addictive energy. Okay? You realize that that has to happen if you don't want to continue to repeat it no matter who you break up with. You know what I'm trying to say? Same for masculine. Because you guys are seeing how it starts to create the conflict. On masculine side, it was the chaos card, right? On your guys' side is hostility and unrest. So it ends up putting you in this mode. You know, being reckless sexually, appeasing the sexual addictions of masculine energy, or whether you're the addict. It creates these hostilities between people. It creates conflict and unrest because it is a reckless behavior. It's chaotic and careless to the effects of those that are involved. Right? So you all are realizing like that creates unrest. Makes you feel like you can't trust. Make you want to fight. You know what I'm saying? Because motherfuckers, right? It's like, feminists like I'm fencing to kick ass because you know what I'm saying? Oh, man. Now, because feminine mad. She mad. Because look at, ooh, y'all look at, okay. On the feminine side, look what happened. You see that sexuality distorts your view. Look at that. Clarity is in reverse. Toxic sexuality distorts your view. When you keep appeasing sexual addiction, it has distorted your clarity and created hostility. Oh my fucking God.
Because I am one with this energy.
You couldn't regulate your emotions. It's in reverse. By appeasing toxic sexuality or sexual addiction. Oh my God. Hold on. Even if it ain't in reverse, let's turn it up right just to make sure. Hell, let's just do it. Oh no, that was in reverse. This is in reverse. This one is. You couldn't regulate your emotions. You created misunderstandings in your life every time you appeased sexual addiction, duality, misunderstandings. Some of y'all got blamed for shit. You know what I'm saying? Oh my God. It got you off track, unawakened. It kept it closed. Oh my God.
I am so grateful for everything.
It blocked your ability to move obstacles. You lost blessings. The harvest is in reverse. When you appease sexual addiction or toxic masculine sexual energy, you get in your feelings, you know what I'm saying? Deep emotions that you don't understand why they're there, with unknown feelings, past life influences. You feel haunted when you appease that. It affects your psychic ability. Now you guys know that though. Wow. Your power, summoning powers in reverse, straight up. When you appease sexual addiction. Wow. Fuck me. No boundaries. Oh, shit.
To experience.
No illumination. Look at this. The feminine is seeing this now. Yeah.
I am so grateful that
I didn't even get the card out. I just got excited. I'm like, what the hell? All right, 19. Did I get the card for the feminine energy? Did I? Death and rebirth.
To know my purpose, or at least see how.
And didn't I say the feminine is going through her transformation, though, or has already, from darkness to light regarding sexual addiction? Whether it is you were sexual, you know, in sexual addiction, or you were just appeasing masculine energy that was in sexual addiction. You ended that shit. 19 breaking down to a 10, baby. You ended that shit. Christ consciousness surrounding you, protecting you while you rebuild yourself and stuff, because you guys see the devastation now. You see it, right? Because you're trying to get back into hopefulness and optimism, because you guys see that going down the path of sexual addiction, or you will see that it takes away hope, it takes away optimism, because that is a fast sliding ride to hell. And when I say hell, I'm not talking about religious nut hell kind of shit. When I say hell, I'm talking about the chaos and the toxicity and the pain and the suffering and the destruction that is absolute to happen when individuals stay in sexual addiction or continue to appease it.
I get to be a part of this amazing.
It's an absolute at some point. And that's where they want me to end it, with that whole sexual thing there. So sex addiction, that's what this portion of it was about, y'all. Okay. And this is insane. I wasn't expecting this. This represents the masculine side. This represents the feminine side. Oddly enough, whoever this channeling was for is actually higher level feminines and masculines, because divine energy came through twice. The master teacher card came out on the masculine side. As well as divine feminine. On feminine side, masculine is in fallen angel mode, teeter-tottering. He chose to kind of stay in the dark side because he don't want to deal with the process, because he came with knowing. He knows what that process is. And it's easier to stay in that lower vibration. For feminine, feminine got tired. She saw the same things that masculine saw. feminine kind of more so leaning towards total transformation. Some of the masculines are awakening. Some of them are slowly starting to kind of think, okay, wait a minute. I need my emotions healed. I think I want to come out of this. Some of them are just simply entertaining the thought, okay, of transformation. The most of the feminines on this side, they already embraced it. Okay. Wow. All right, so now let's move on. I don't know who that's for, but there y'all go. That's something different. Sexual addiction. Very toxic. Have very catastrophic effects. Can really hurt lives. Shouldn't be taken lightly. We really shouldn't laugh and hee hee and ha ha at that. And you know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's insane. Okay, light team, let's go. Now they want to go to that next topic I told y'all about. Okay, so the other thing, message that was coming to me was about emotions. And what do you guys think about that? How do you feel about emotions? How do you relate to emotions? How do you allow yourself to experience crying? That's what the emotions was about, crying. Right? I don't know what kind of reading they want me to be able to give y'all with that, but the there was a movie clip that came to my mind that was called Something's Gotta Give. It's an older movie with Diane Keaton and Jack Nicholson. And, you know, they ended up messing around. He was a typical egotistical older guy that only went for the younger chicks. She was an accomplished older woman. They were the same age, had accomplished many wonderful things in her life. You know, she was beautiful and healthy and all that in her own right. But he always went for the younger chick. Classic, you know, stereotypes, you know, cliche, right? So, but in eventually they kind of started hanging out and dating, and he felt, you know, something for her and vice versa. He was shocked, but he did, right? But he was still egotistical. He still had that deep roots in him, right? So he ended up breaking her heart, and you know, like, to her surprise, she thought this was about to be. They both opened up to each other, you know what I'm saying? And to her surprise, right, she called him, you know what I'm saying, woo woo. She called him, you know what I'm saying, at the restaurant and shiznit with some young hoe, right? So, you know, she was like, what? You know, and then, so she was all upset about it, you know. And at first, she was just mad and angry, and she kind of just went about her work. She was a very hardworking woman, okay? She was a world-renowned writer, okay? So she was accomplished, okay, in herself. And so she just kind of dove into that, you know, like, whatever, you know what I'm saying? But she noticed that she had a block, right? Because she's a writer. So as she kept, like, trying to not deal with her feeling, her emotion, as she kept trying to, like, oh, you know, I'm an adult, I'm an accomplished woman, you know what I'm saying? Shit, life goes on, woo-woo. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? She had young doctors want her ass. You know what I'm saying? Because she was a beautiful woman, right? So, but the more she resisted feeling, I'm going somewhere, you guys, bear with me. The more she resisted feeling and allowing herself to cry, she ended up getting a writer's block. She's a writer. So she was sitting, you know, like, she doing her thing, but she couldn't. Like, she was just trying to write mechanically and sheerly based on her skill. But then when she tapped into how she felt, she allowed herself to, like, ugly cry. And she just kept, you know, it'll come in spurts. She just let it go. She went on a walk on the beach, and she was like, ooh! You know, she's like, let it glow. Every time it came up, and she just started crying and typing, right? So the message is that, you know, it is uncomfortable, right? Her daughter even said, like, her daughter didn't want to ever feel that. She was like, I don't ever want to be that way. I don't ever want to feel that, because who wants that? You know, yada, yada, yada. And the mom, Diane Keaton, was like, no, babe, no, sweetheart. We must feel and experience all of it. This is the richness of life. It is a part of it. And we grow and we go on. But we connect to the rawness that we felt something so deeply. We allow ourselves to feel that. She was like, she knew it was painful. She was like, but no, you don't want to bypass that. And so what I feel like the message is like when we refuse to allow these things, we only get stuck. Like she got stuck. We get stagnant. We end up only operating mechanically from sheer skill like she was. She was accomplished. She didn't need shit. But she was blocked off. She was numb. She was hollow. It wasn't happening. There was no inspiration. Her tears brought inspiration. Hear me out. Her tears brought inspiration. Her feeling the pain birthed her creations. Okay? Her allowing herself to take her time, because this happened for days in on out. She took her time. She would be doing fine and she would just burst into tears. And she would walk on the beach and cry. Okay? Or she would sit at her desk writing and she'll be fine, but then she'll get something and hit her and she'll just cry and let herself, instead of like, no, I'm not gonna cry. I'm not gonna cry. I'm not gonna cry. She'll just cry. And next thing you know, she's typing. She's typing. Okay? So ask yourself, how do you feel about crying? Because it doesn't it feel raw, you guys? Doesn't it feel vulnerable? Like, think about those times. It make you feel like you're gonna die. It make you feel like you can't, you know what I'm saying? Because you're connecting to the depth, right? But that's good. The tears is actually cleansing to the soul. It's actually an honor and a salute to your experience that you had, okay? It's a validation to it, which essentially releases you. When we hold it, we can be long past gone, the experience or the individuals involved, right? But it's still there. It's still there causing what? Blockage. So by feeling, it gets it through the body. It validates it. Emotions, feeling, allowing yourself to cry, letting go of the cultural things we all come from. Oh, that means you're a weak bitch. No, you're a weak bitch if you're trying to pretend like you're not hurt and you don't want to cry. It's the ego trying to protect you because you feel like if you do, then you're going to fall apart. As for masculine, oh, I don't want to cry because it makes me seem like a simp. No, you're a simp. When you try to pretend like you don't, you know what I'm saying? Like you don't feel nothing. You know what I'm trying to say? This is honoring. Crying and tears are honoring to our experiences. It shows that you are a fucking human being and you felt something and you were able to care for something or someone so deeply. It means you're not a fucking robot. It means you're not heartless. It means you have the capacity to be affected in life. And that's a beautiful thing, a part of the human experience. It's also the catapult of how you will grow and create things in life. How it's going to cleanse your soul of things that happen. Keep you connected to your emotion body versus becoming hard and disconnected. Hiding behind accomplishment. Hiding behind skill, hiding behind clout, hiding behind money, hiding behind hoes, hiding behind cars, hiding behind this, hiding behind that.
Free from all feelings of insecurity and stress.
Emotion. Do you let yourself cry? I was challenged in that way, y'all. The only way I get to come on here and do stuff is if I get challenged. That's kind of my resonance. I have to get challenged in something on some level. And graduate on some level.
I am enjoying this adventure.
Blew my mind. Because I had a thought and belief that it wasn't as simple for me as, oh, I think I'm a weak. For me, I went through times where I felt like, because I'm a crybaby by nature. So if you're a crybaby by nature, you get to a point in life where you feel like, well, fuck shit. I ain't crying another goddamn time behind another goddamn thing. You know what I'm saying? Is if you were that kind of person like myself, cry on a dime, right? But I was equally wrong. My light team came in. I was equally wrong because mine was more about, okay, I don't want to cry no more because this, or I felt like it was like, oh, that's what it was. Thank you, light team. I was like, I told my light team, but if I let myself cry like that or go that deep in, then I'm gonna become susceptible or vulnerable to wanting to be with these people, and I don't want to be with these people anymore. That's what I told my light team. I thought that it was gonna make me susceptible because it is a vulnerable feeling. The love is always in the heart. Love is very pure. So when we feel that deeply, that disappointment, that betrayal, that loss, that, you know, that toxicity, that abuse, whatever happened, when we connect to it, there's a vulnerability. And if a person is pure-hearted, the love is always in the heart and soul, is there. And so I mistook it. I thought, okay, if I keep letting myself feel that, it's going to make me want to put myself in situations that my higher self has already shown me that was not good, that it was going to make me want to run back to toxic things. And that was a myth. It wasn't true. And my team showed me that. That it was an honor to my experience, but I had gained too much wisdom. That as you grow, feeling your feelings is not going to negate the wisdom that you've attained. It's not going to stop you from being able to make a healthy choice. And that's what I thought it would do. So ask yourself that, like, you know, whenever you feel guided to, of course, but I can certainly attest, you know, that's what I thought. I was like, I done already cried, team. I done did that. Going to give me a Reiki, I'm finna do something else. You know what I'm saying? I was like, nuh-uh. Right? And they were like, no, Brandy, there's no time stamp. That's another conditioning and a cultural mindset. Who the fuck said, who said it gotta be? No. It's about progression, movement, but you don't get, okay, 4 days. You got 4 days. You know what I'm saying? It's like, no. I also thought it would take away my strength. My strength to go on in life or my strength to do life. Because I used to say shit like, ain't nobody got no time for no emotional weeping. At this point, team, I'm always crying. Got shit to do. That was like my attitude. They're like, no. Things come up when they're ready, princess. They come up when they're ready to be felt and released and alchemized. It's not a program and a schedule. So when it happens, give yourself permission and then move on. Detach. You ain't got to attach to it. I thought you have to stay attached to these things. And they're like, no, they're emotions. Feel them. And then you move on. Just like Diane Keaton. She felt her emotions. But she didn't stay in the bed for 4 weeks. She felt them. She gave herself room. Usually people stay in the bed for 4 weeks because they shut down somewhere and didn't face off. So she felt, but she kept moving the whole time. So she didn't stop writing. She kept writing. It actually pushed her. But I erroneously thought that it would hinder me. So I hope that helps somebody, because it won't, whether you're a man or a woman. You giving yourself sacred space to sincerely and thoroughly cry. That ugly cry. Not the cute, I'm on Instagram TV, but I want to show I got emotions, but it's fake as fuck. Not that kind of cry. Okay. I'm talking about the ugly cry that is nothing cute about it at all. Okay. Ain't no photo shoot, nothing. You heard? And you'll find that you feel lifted and free. I could attest to that. That every time, you know, with it, if you set that intention, like I started doing, I set an intention. I said, all right, team, well, whatever, whenever. And I set an intention. I said, all right. I'll go when it happens, But my intention is for validation. My intention is for alchemy. My intention is in the name of validating and honoring myself and what I experienced. But at the end of the day, my intention is to let this shit go. To let go of the story, to let go of the individuals, whatever that is, and move on. Yep. I set those intentions. Because I was like, I ain't finna be replaying this. But they were like, just roll with it. And you do feel lighter and lighter and lighter. And it's okay. Like, you get to a point where it's like, oh, it's okay that I'm crying. It doesn't mean that I haven't healed. It doesn't mean that I'm not growing. It just means the depth of you. Some things were deep. Sometimes we came from a lot of toxic pain shit that we didn't really get a chance to fully process. Sometimes people done some heinous shit to us. Okay? And we can't put it in a box. You know what I mean? Like, oh, it's two times. Two times. And look it, we got, again, that butterfly jumped out again. And this time we got the brilliant virgin. It's like getting your purity back, your innocence back through tears. You know what I'm saying? The tears of what has happened through experiences that hurt. Okay, whether you're a man or a woman. And look it, out of darkness. Out of darkness. Wow. That's insane. See, crying is a good thing. Crying cleanses the soul. Crying, look at this. Death shall not take him. It couldn't kill you. You know, crying is not going to kill you. Okay, touching those emotions and letting yourself, it's a transformative energy. This is like the death card in tarot. Okay, and again, with the brilliant virgin, it gives you your purity back. It restores your purity. It restores your hope, your vibrancy by validating things and allowing yourself to feel it and let it cleanse, right? The tears. And this, of course, you know, you ain't got to be outside. I mean, you want to feel comfortable and like you're in a safe and sacred space to do it. But allow yourself it. You know what I mean? You ain't got to be to extended brandy, crybabies and shit her whole life. See, look, and then here comes the celebration, confetti. You know, after the tears comes the confetti, y'all. Now you feel lighter, you feel hopeful and vibrant, and like you could celebrate again. I'm telling y'all. That's how Diane Keaton felt. Through that, she was able to feel better and she moved on. In her case, you know, she got back with that person, but that's not what this reading is about. Because she had options. Fire coming back with that red hair. Yeah. It says Clown of Crossroads. Yeah. See, this reminds me of like indecision, crossroads, things that you've gone through, looking at that stuff, and allowing yourself to look at it and feel that. That clown looks sad. Is this Harlequin? Maven a mask. Ooh, look at this. Look, y'all. Look, check this out. See, when we don't cry, when we don't allow ourselves the authentic process, when it comes to cry, I'm not talking about making yourself. But when it's coming up and we try to stuff it, or we busy all angry, or, you know, but when it's meant just to sit and feel your feelings, then now we just hide behind our mask. The Maven, a mask. Right? Like I said, Diane Keaton, she was able to still function on her sheer skill, but it was bland. She was blocked. Yeah, see, you want to tap back into that gypsy energy. High vibration, of course, but just that freedom. You know, gypsies are known, you know, free-spirited people, vibrant. I'm not talking about the folklore or the low vibration of that. Divine disguise. See, For some of you, like I said, it's almost like we go through, I see this two ways, because to a degree, you don't want to put your stuff on display. Okay, everybody don't need to know all your business. That's not even what the reading is about. It's not for everybody to know. It's an intimate thing. Okay, putting it on blast status, right? So through your healing process, you are divinely disguised. That's one of the message. Because if you're in healing mode, you got the universe and source covering you and backing you up. They're not going to let you be exploited. See, many of you, if you're like me, you were concerned about that too. Because what happens is when you go, if you're in the public or if you're on a platform or just in your life around social circles, whatever, when people see sometime that you're vulnerable, if they're not the right vibration, they can try to come in and exploit it. That was a part of what I told my team. So when we surrender to the process, whatever it is that you do for work, whatever it is that you have to, you know, that you have created in your life that requires you to show up, right? You will still be divinely disguised, covered in glory. Not because you're trying to fake, but because you're doing the inner work. But as you're in the process of your vulnerability, by your guidance team will not be allowed to be exploited as you stay in that alignment, okay? Other times where this is not about that surrender and protection is more about hiding. This is the side of people who don't want to cry, who don't want to do that inner work, but they want to present like they are this. Okay? That's not going to work. That's not going to work. Not very long. Because that kind of protection is meant, you know, to just keep people safe and comfortable and go on their journeys, but not to keep people in a toxic state or keep people in a state of not connecting to their feelings, emotions, and things like that. It's not meant for that. Huh. Okay, I'm about to get the card, you guys. All right, what's the message from here since y'all have me to get this light team? And then I'm done. Right? Am I done? Regarding emotions, crying, for those this message is for. Ooh, fuck me. Her wicked ways. Did y'all see that? Boom. Well, if it ain't the karmic queen. Well, well, well. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all? Not you, wicked queen. Card number 19. Breaking down to a 10. So, you know, ending cycles with, you know what I'm saying, connecting to feminine energies that were wicked towards you. And giving yourself permission to feel, you guys, what her wicked ways caused you, which means crying. Okay, because the Ice Queen here, she may look pretty and she may present that way, but yeah. Very icy and cutthroat, insensitive to people. Okay. And seeing many of you all are in this energy, look at the vast difference. Look at all this color. Go fish. Card number 9. We got 2 9s here. All right. Card number 9. To me, this is about, I see 2 fish. It's about rebirth. It's about new beginnings. It's about balancing to that yin and yang. It's about embracing life, vibrancy, ending the old things, embracing life. Look at that color. uniqueness.
I am so
these individuals maybe have gotten severely hurt by ice princesses. Okay. Whoever that represents for you, male or female, whether you are male or female or whether they are male or female, but a very uncaring, unloving, insensitive feminine energy.
I am present to life.
This is y'all, but this is probably why.
So I can see
the Velvet Queen. Hold on, let me see why. Aw, look at y'all. Aww. This is, I see why. It's almost like that Snow White story and shit and the mirror, mirror. That's like the dynamic and shit, isn't it? And see, all you guys are doing is just trying to play your hand, man. Because, you know, hell, you're already, you know, you're like, well, fuck me. You know, but the guidance is, you know, play your hand, but let yourself feel your feelings. Let yourself cry. Yeah, there's that butterfly again. People wanted you to feel like you were a loser. And see, and that's something else you guys need to let yourself cry about. Look at this. You guys have dealt with a lot of people in your life, okay? No matter what these dynamics were that were trying to make you, which is actually a princess, okay? By the way, pay attention. She has a crown. The card says Princess Victorious. The card number 6 that represents balance all day long. But if you look close, look at her finger. It says a loser. Many of you have dealt with people that wanted to silence you, that wanted to make you feel like a loser, that's trying to shut you down, that's trying to smear your name, that wanted you to feel like you were insignificant, okay? Because essentially you are a princess and they wanted your crown. That's who they really are. And you see how she's been crying? Yeah. Because she was silenced for a long time. Because she was listening to these motherfuckers. Being bullied by these kind of people. Whether it was a man or a woman. Okay. That's what they wanted you to think. But this is why you got to let yourself feel that, because sometimes you guys come into the realization of this stuff, it can be a lot.
And to serve each other.
And so you're just like, okay, I'm just going to move on, shit, fuck that. Diane Keaton, I'm accomplished, fuck it. I can do shit. Okay, get it. But go ahead and cry, princess, okay? All masks are coming off. Not only does it take off the mask, the illusions that they try to project onto you or try to keep you hidden, right? Or seen in a certain way. The truth is they were in mask. Okay? Wow. Light team. Or people that were jugglers juggling you. Trying to make you feel like the loser and they were the losers.
I get to give myself.
Having you in circuses and shit. Love circus. Fuck shit.
I get to experience the freedom of abundant wealth.
And it needs to be validated that it happened. Oh, some of y'all got Egyptian roots.
I get to live with
it. Ra is here. The god Ra, and I believe Ra probably is stepping in, you know, just to avenge and assist, you know, with healing and clearing in terms of some injustices here. But the sunshine is coming in. You got backup. You gotta let yourself cry though. You don't gotta be that good geisha no more, and that's where people wanted to keep you. The good geisha. Here to the service of all, to her demise, to make other people feel better and uplifted while they try to minimize her.
I appreciate the enormous wealth and all the abundance.
And she too is crying. Check it out. You ain't gotta be no damn good geisha, motherfuckers. Cause you are an individual here with the rooster mama. You guys are fucking, you know what I'm saying, vibrant and colorful and eccentric and unique, and you finna go on roost. Roost, goddammit. Whatever that sound is, you know what I'm saying? I don't know what the sound is to the roost. It's like, no, fuck that. But look, as you cry, validate what you feel. Because you're brilliant and shining, and nobody's gonna, like that movie Dirty Dancing, Home Dude said, nobody puts baby in a corner. Nobody sits baby down. And I feel like that's your spirit guides and your light team and Ra and whoever the fuck these ice princesses and shiznit is, saying to all them, nobody sits them down. Nobody puts them in the background. Nobody is going to dim their shine or their uniqueness. If we say they supposed to be seen, goddammit, then they going to be seen. Because she's Lady Luck. Luck is in her favor. Loving. Thank you. Because these fake fucks, Dukes of Shadows and shit. But I am surrounded by luxury. All in the shadows, stalking and shit, doing crazy shit behind the scene, thinking nobody don't know. Oh, it's so known. It's known. The Joker's wild, right? It's known. Oh, so you guys are being reborn, bright baby. Wow. And people don't like that, but, you know, it's just about validate your feelings, let yourself cry, because you guys are equally this warrior as you are that other princess. You will fuck some shit up. You ain't no joke. You are forced to be reckoned with yourself now. It's like, yeah, I'm the princess, and the princess will cry. But when the princess come out of crying, and you come at me crazy, you're going to wish you didn't.
My mind feels free and relaxed.
Keep fucking with my shit. You're going to wish you didn't. Because those of you who are in this reading, you guys are raw, rare, and real. No matter who don't like you, honey. And they dizzy as limited as opinions. Okay.
I enjoy feeling a part of this loveliness.
You guys have a date with destiny. Ain't nobody gonna finna stop this. Ice Princess, I ain't gonna be able to do shit about it.
To be me and to be
because you guys are a sweetheart. And have always been. And you have tasted the blood and have eaten
so
nothing but toxicity. Look at her, got wounds and shit. Nothing but a sweetheart. People attacking maybe what you say, what you do, what you speak, attacking you. But in essence, you're really a sweetheart, though. But they trying to make it seem like, you know what I'm saying? Without this blood right here putting shit on you. But they were the fucked up motherfuckers. Yeah.
Even as I sit here now, in this
they didn't understand that you couldn't be taken out.
Listening to this beautiful music.
Many of you have a voice of an angel. And unfortunately, some people don't even like that. Fuck. It's twisted.
I am so grateful for every moment of flowing wealth.
Sad, man. Help me, team. There's the magician. What's meant for you, they can't stop. Ice Princess can't do nothing about it.
The continuous flow.
And sometimes, okay, some of you, you kind of like block the crying process because you wanted to stay focused on your manifestations, you know, naturally so, and what's meant for you. And of course, but I feel like your light teams are saying, yeah, that laser sharp focus is what's got you here. But you're not going to have to do the effort in that way. Allow yourself to feel and cry and continue on your path But don't ignore the crying part, a validating of what have happened to you. Ice Princess and nobody else, whatever gang fuck shit they do, they really can't stop what's meant for you. They can attack your name. They can attack your platform. They could play games. They can go in and out. They can subscribe, unsubscribe, follow, unfollow. You know what I'm saying? They could whatever the fuck. You know what I'm saying? Essentially this. What's meant for you is meant for you. All in divine order and timing. But it's imperative that you continue to allow yourself, if it's coming up for you to feel and cry, give yourself that permission. It's actually a strength. It actually supports your manifestation like it did Diane Keaton. She turned her pain into a paper. She turned her pain into a fucking play, a book. Okay? Same as you guys. As you allow yourself to feel. Yep, there it is. Throat chakra. As you guys allow yourself to feel and express that. Create a sacred space for yourself, of course. Your manifestation is going to be actually heightened. Because Diane Keaton took off when she started letting herself cry, where she had got that blockage and that stagnant, it flowed. And that play became world renowned and something big and shit. Her story of getting done over, fucked over, basically. Yeah, I'm just saying, you guys. Yeah. Dark Harlequin ain't gonna be able to do shit for you. Or against you, it ain't gonna stand, okay? The Wicked Way Queen and the Dark Harlequin, you know what I'm saying, that y'all been plagued with, no power. All right? No power. No power. Your Princess Victorious. Victorious. Da, da, da. Or is it Victorious or Notorious? But we're going to say Victorious. Da, 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 da. Victorious. As you cry, Victorious. Da, da, na, na, da, na, 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 na. Victorious, right? Oh, man. All right, team. I think we're done. This is a dynamic reading, like, team. Got me kind of taken aback here a little bit. So this was regarding emotions and regarding crying here. What's been happening? Is there anything else, team, before I shut her off? Are we good? Are we good to go? All right. So tell them what they need to know as they embrace this whole message and system. All right. Oh, fuck me. I am a generator of wealth. What'd I say? Abundance. You are good enough, motherfuckers. You're good enough. In your face, Ice Princesses. Abundance is for some of y'all, a new romantic cycle is beginning, new moon in Libra, if for those of you who are interested or you know, trying to manifest the romance, okay? But it's going to be balance and justice. That's what you need to know. As you embrace your tears, though, you may have to cry some tears that you've been holding back, maybe regarding another love, right? Or friendship or connection or, you know? Yeah. Victorious. Okay, so this says your commitment is being tested, and what I'm guided to say with this is that your commitment to yourself, because you are good enough, your commitment to allow yourself to connect with your emotions and feel your feels and cry and stay on your journey where you're at and keep at it, knowing that you're good enough no matter what obstacles are coming your way, no matter what, even the emotions that come up that make you feel jaunted and make you feel uncomfortable, that makes you feel weak. What your team is telling you, that's just energy. It's the process of validating what you've experienced. And it's natural, but you're good enough even when you're crying. You're good enough even when you don't have all the shit figured out. You're good enough, you know what I'm saying, with mascara coming down your eyes and shit like the princess over here because she dealt with fuck shit. But you're good enough through it all. Your commitment to you is being tested, who you are and what you believe in, going for your hopes and dreams, whatever that means. Against every ice queen. Listen, and as I said that, you're very close to achieving your goal. The emotion part may have been like the cherry on the top, like they gotta let that water out. They gotta let that emotion. They gotta cry. They gotta let it happen. It's not gonna take away from your confidence. Many of you erroneously believe that if you're crying, it means that you're not confident. That's not true. It's not. It means you're human. It means growth. Think about when a woman is having a baby and she's pushing, honey, if she's remotely halfway normal, she's not sitting there with not a moan or a tear. Usually she's looking kind of some kind of way because it's a process, right? Look it, and look at this, you guys, a new start is coming, new moon, and we're in the new moon in the next couple of days. Ooh. Yeah. Ooh, light team, this is good. The answers that you need are coming. Full moon in Gemini. This may happen at the next full moon. So like 27-day cycle here. Whatever is pertaining to whatever the tears are for you, okay? That release, right? Whatever that's about, whether it's a lover, a friend, an ex, family members, co-workers, bosses, motherfuckers, cyber stalkers, jealous competitors, whoever the fuck, right? I'm just saying. All right, team. Let's close them out. What's the messages you guys want them to know? Those that resonate with this reading regarding allowing themselves to cry as a catalyst of their creation and creativity and healing and continuing to move forward and manifest. Boom. Show the world the real you, baby. Yeah, and what I'm picking up with this for y'all is don't hide your glory, goddammit. Fuck the bullshit. These motherfuckers, see, here comes that anger light team. Here it comes. I'm feeling that energies again. Because these people wanted the Princess Victorious to be hidden. Yeah. It fell over onto Princess Victorious. And this, ooh, go on, light team. Okay, I got you. So for some of y'alls, what this is this. I can totally relax. Those delusional, demented fucks wanted you to feel like a loser. Wanted you to see yourself as a loser. That although it is magnificent to have, wanted you to present that way. But you are no loser. You're a princess. More than that. Victorious. Victorious. Mm-mm-mm. Show the world that. Show the motherfuckers. Right? That's what I pick up with that. Woo! Gone. Because you're not what people try to put on you so they can feel better about themselves. I have time and money, freedom. Victorious. Wow. The issue is these people didn't want people to be able to see the real you, but they can't stop it. Anything else? Can't stop it. The more they try, the more they gonna land in more and more misery. Light team? Stuff is not what makes one happy.
Ooh.
A fiery climax is coming.
It certainly makes life
and what I feel like what's happening is this. People are gonna be exposed. Okay, that's something you guys need to know. Cry your tears, beautiful souls. Those of you who are resonating with this reading, being asked to connect to your feelings. But the universe is always at play. There's always background energy happening. And where they try to portray you in a certain way, where they've tried to project certain shit and try to say you were wearing a mask and try to say you were fake and you were this and you were that, okay? Try to paint an image. The Ice Princess is about to be exposed with the world, show the world the real them. And the only reason why that's happening is because, they, first of all, they shouldn't have fucked with royalty. They wouldn't have taken their hands and their mouth off of the princess. Wrong move. The second reason is because they refuse their own transformation. And they're trying to go around shape-shifting. They're trying to switch. They're trying to proclaim the image of the Princess Victorious on themselves and put the image of their wicked ways onto the Princess Victorious. And because they're doing that, they're about to get exposed. Victorious. 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 A personal issue reaches resolution. I just told y'all, shit going down. Source, my team, they start getting mad after a point. Like, it's like, look, my fuckers, everybody need to do their inner work and their journey and shit. Leave my fuckers alone. That ain't bothering you. Get your shit together. Okay. Anything else, light team? Yeah. Stay at it, souls. The energy is gaining momentum. So keep doing your healing, your practices, your meditation. You know, now allow yourself to cry. You know, you got some deep wounds, you know, from these wicked way people and dark harlequins and shit. Okay? Keep at what you're doing. Don't stop. Hold your vision. No matter how what you're doing is being attacked, and you know what I'm saying? Essentially, people that spend their time and energy trying to come after somebody else's career or their creations and things, usually. Okay, so every assault that happens, every insult, every, you know what I'm saying, game and whatever the fuck these people think they're doing, prayers, magic, bind, whatever the fuck, you know, it's gonna backfire, and it's gonna backfire hard. But you're being asked to hold your vision because there's a process. It's a process. You're gaining momentum. I But sometimes you can feel Ice Princess's energies and Harlequins and the dark motherfuckers. You can feel their energy. And some of them show up in disguise on your platforms if you have them. But you're being asked, hold your vision. Because you're victorious. Victorious. Okay, last card. I'm being silly now. Boom. I love this feeling of freedom and satisfaction. Boom. With myself and look it. As you work through your fears, you guys, of, you know, first of all, crying, allowing yourself to feel that gut-wrenching pain and cry, right? But also letting yourself be seen, because remember, the thing was, these motherfuckers, right? They didn't want you to be attention whores. They erroneously feel like by you getting attention, it means that they can't and won't. That's fear, ego-based energy is very primitive and is actually very petty. But that's how they feel.
I'm so good.
And that's why they try to sabotage you. All right? And many of you feel that energy. And some of you all feel like, well, you know, you kind of hold yourself back because you're kind of getting sick of the fuck shit. But it says show the world. You're victorious. Victorious. show the world. Work through your fear. Fear of being seen.
And what a blissful experience.
Fear of the ice princesses of the world and the dark holoclans that's bound to come, because you're going to always have some low vibrational fucks.
Feeling so at ease.
Because with this new moon, a new start is coming for many of you. Cry them tears.
I know there
victorious.
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 Right now,
I'm feeling this now. Victorious.
I feel deep.
Yeah. Yay. All right, y'all, I'm gonna stop being silly, but I actually do mean every word of what I'm saying. Hopefully it is inspiring y'all. That's what I hope. If this is resonating with you, if this is your story, right? I hope these motherfuckers, y'all's here. These hoes over here. It's you manifesting what's meant for you. And the irony in all of these kind of dynamics is everybody could create and have this, you know, whatever opportunities their souls came here to do. There's an abundance in the universe. That's the irony. But when people choose to not heal and stay low vibrational, and they choose to project their shit on other people that's going about their life and just simply trying to live their best life, this is why the shit be ending and how they be ending and why shit be how it be for them. Okay? It's not that one is better than the other. Has nothing at all to do with that. Though they'll try to portray that shit in their conversations, right? But essentially, this is about, and the dynamics like these, there's a group that decided to heal. It's a group that decided to mind their business and go on their paths and let that shit, you know what I'm saying, that hurt them be used to make something great instead of trying to go witch hunt and you know what I'm saying, blame and slander even the very people that actually did fucking hurt them. And because these people were incessant on doing that shit, they gonna reap it. That's why. It ain't because the princess is better. It's because the princess made a choice that they didn't want to make. Somebody said facts. Right? Are you victorious? Whoever resonating with this here reading. Victorious. Don't mind me, y'all. I'm silly now. Somebody said, yes, ma'am. Somebody said, Amun Ra. Yeah, absolutely. Amun Ra, you guys. Some of y'all got some Egyptian roots or the gods stepped in or some shit. Y'all got some heavyweights back in some of y'all up here. I felt that energy. I'm like, ooh, these people better leave these people alone. Shit. For it be more than they need to stop. Why they still got a little bit of sanity. Somebody said exactly, yes. This is most men are raised to not cry. Yeah, absolutely. So that's why I felt like my team wanted me to kind of really talk about it. Because we all have these different cultures that make us shut down from the emotion.
I trust that I'm always.
Yeah, he did. What is his name? Jack Nicholson dated the daughter in the movie. Yep.
The universe has proven this to be time.
Truth. Hope it does, because most of them are questionable beings, and I mean that in every sense. Woo! Somebody says at blah blah blah. It's because they're off balance, but it catches up to them eventually. The sexuality reading, yeah, it catches up with all of us. Ooh, is this pretty? I just saw like this big, huge heart. What the hell? That is so adorable. Thank you, whoever sent that. It was so pretty. Somebody said, I've been doing my shadow work. Yeah, I know it's no joke, you guys. I don't mean to make light of it at all for any of us, but it's worth it, you know. It will catch up. not spiritual love. Exactly. You know, that sex, that sex addiction, that's not love, but that's what they equate it to when they decide to stay locked in that energy because of that trauma and those early experiences. It says, but why the how do other girls get away with it? No, whoever said that, if you're even still here, honey, nobody do. See, that's why I kept saying, if you pay close attention, I was like, whether the, you know, if the feminine was in the addiction or she just appeased it, nobody do. It's always devastation for everybody. The feminines aren't getting away. The feminines usually get nothing, but, you know, if she's using people for sex or whatever her reason, it's the same. She suffers the consequence. It may look differently than it looks in the masculine form, but you can't reap healthy. Like, she suffers, but what happens is feminines oftentimes, don't ask me why, I don't have it all figured out, guys, but oftentimes what happens is feminines start waking up a little quicker than masculine energy. I think that's what happens. If whoever is waking up first and start like being diligent on their work, then of course they're healing and clearing up their path. What happens is sometimes masculines will stagnate, and because they stagnate, it seems like they're suffering more and it seems like it's taking longer, but it's not because it's a bias, it's because of his choice. Feminines start to say, okay, fuck this, I got hurt too much, I'm tired of this, whoa. And so they start yielding. But masculine, sometimes it takes them a longer period to catch a clue. Okay, and it's because of the culture, though. We have a culture that has conditioned and programs that praises toxic masculine energy and exploits sexuality to exploit the feminine. And because that's the conditioning, then it's like the masculine's working with that program, then he's working with the program of his own life trauma, his ancestry. So sometimes it takes them a lot longer to want to even come out. Because, I mean, hell, if you're getting praised and all this shit as a masculine, hell, it may take you a longer time to catch a clue that it's going to catch up with that ass. You heard me? But that's why I just wanted to say that, because nobody gets away, whoever said that, not nobody. Holding on to not letting go. Yeah, something always goes wrong in those situations where it switched. Yeah, you guys are on point, all of you that was making these comments here. Man, somebody said spirit led you here. Narcissist. Ooh, girl, whoever said narcissist, yeah, well, that's, yeah, I ain't finna get into that. But I'm trying to see if I can see anything so I could try to acknowledge y'all a little bit more. It says, now I'll be a hoe. Did somebody hold on, I want to see what y'all say right here. Somebody says, now I'll be a hoe so he can watch. And now see, we've all been there. I ain't gonna lie to you, you know, I ain't always been 45 and I ain't always been in this place. But you know, that's just your pain talking. Love and honor yourself better than that. If you really want to get that revenge, it's ascend and choose something better. And they, guess what? If source sees fit, they're going to have to watch that too. Okay? If they did some kind of fucked up shit, they will have to watch that. You live a healthy life and make healthy choices and get a love far beyond their fuck shit. Okay? I'm just saying. They will. Dealing with someone like him. I'm telling y'all, I've been down the road. Oh, Bloomy Blooms, no shit. Okay, she done lived some shiznit. I'm telling y'all, it took me a minute too. Wait. To realize, like, let me feel my feels. Let me go and cry and stop, you know, let me do the shit. My team is trying to get me to go and do. And no. Sexual addiction is toxic. Sexual addiction, or appeasing to someone's sexual addiction, is destined for destruction and hurt and pain. It is destined for it. It is. We can have healthy love, balanced love, and still be exciting and still be exhilarating. You know, we have all these myths that are, you know, that are told us, man. Oh, it's boring if you're not, what's boring if I'm not putting myself at risk by fucking everybody on the planet? Really, though?
I get to choose my experiences and my
friends. I'm just saying. Really? Okay. That's an indication right there that there are some addictive energies and behaviors going on. How about you keep on and that thing ain't gonna be able to be used? How about that? Due to sexual addiction. How about that? Then who you fucking? You know what I'm just saying. Like, see, we gotta look at it like the destruction. And when people are in addiction, they don't see destruction, you guys. Just like those on crack, whatever the hell. They don't see that their teeth is falling out and shit. They don't see that they look fucked up. They don't see that they're dizzy as hell. They don't see that they got on two left shoes and two totally different kind of shoes. And they don't see none of that because they're just chasing these addictions. But they don't have a clear view and perception of the devastation it's doing to their lives and those they love. And it is the same with sexual addiction. They're no exception. It's an actual thing. If you guys don't believe me, Google it. It's a thing. It makes them reckless. Very reckless. They don't see how dizzy as fuck, just like the crack addict. They don't see that they fucked up. You know what I'm saying? They don't see it. They're in illusion.
Laughing and enjoying each other's company.
Just like a crack addict is in illusion when they're chasing those highs, y'all.
And now I sit here relaxed.
All right, guys. I appreciate y'all. I hope this resonates. I will upload this to the YouTube platform for those of you who want to know that. If you subscribe over there, if you're guided, you'll be notified as soon as I'm able to get these lives up for you, okay? If you feel guided to do that, all right? So anyway, I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your weekend. I'm going to try to get some shorts out on the TikTok. The shorts I've been primarily using for like the quickie things, the evening unwinding, the morning exercise, and here and there I'll do like the card of a day there. So, you know, have mercy on me on that side of it, you guys. I know a lot of people like those shorts. I've done a lot of those in the past, but I have a lot going on, and so I'm trying to mix and merge everything best I can. But I will try to do more readings or card readings on the shorts for you guys too. But just in case you didn't know, you can always replay all of these lives on the YouTube channel at Bloom From Within Love, okay? So that's the good thing about it, and you can play with it and go back and forth all day long, right? All right, you guys, I appreciate y'all. Be safe, be well. Somebody said good night. Oh, good night. Thank you so much. Somebody sent some hearts. Ew. Whoever sends the hearts and all the likey likes, thank you. Hugs and kisses. You guys deserve your victory. You're victorious. You deserve your shine. You deserve, you know what I'm saying, all this that source and raw, you know, has in store for you. What you're manifesting. Y'all deserve this shiznit. Now, go ahead and cry your tears. And don't worry about the ice princess and the twisted harlequins and shiznit. May they be well. May they be well. They can't stop shit. You guys keep going. Keep going. Keep believing in yourself, all right? You got this. Love and light. Hugs and kisses. You're not a loser. The motherfuckers is a loser. And I'm going to end it with that. Namaste, right? Namaste, losers. No, I'm just playing. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Okay. Y'all not losers. Y'all the Princess Victorious, okay? Right? Da, na, na, na. Victorious.